Titans, number one, Kamajok. Number three, Alan Tan. Number six, Pranavan Mahenran. Number nine, AJ Beattie. And number 11, 11, Jacob Houston. With their head coach, Paul Cooperis. And for the Bethlehem Stars, number 2, Maurice Aranda. Number 3, Frank Obilo. Number 6, Tatia Tombe. Number 10, Osage Osegal. And number 11, Sam Bassong. With their head coach, Dan Kazoo. And the officials of this match are Yul Kamida and Carl Jaworski. Let's play Grit Basketball.
All right. Here we go, folks. Day 2. Brit 54 in 2024.
Bethlehem Stars versus the Harry Ainley Titans.
That's right. Second game on the B side here. Both these teams lost yesterday. Was that a tray?
Harry Ainley comes out firing with a three right off the hop.
Oh my. I don't know if I'm going to be able to count this high. I have a feeling this is going to be a barn burn. All right, folks. We broke new ground last game. First all-female commentator set up last match. Match? Game.
Game.
Game. Not a match. I'm Famous Amos, and I'm in here with this first time we worked together.
Yes.
We got the Foxtrot in the house here.
The Foxtrot is in the house.
All right. Okay, folks, if you're tuning in from out of town, or maybe you're sitting on your couch here in Toontown, if we're mispronouncing names, don't be afraid to chime in on that chat. In addition, don't be afraid to use the mute button. It's what it's there for. Okay. Bethlehem in the nice, crisp white.
Jacob Houston with another rebound. He is going to be a force on the rebound. 6'5" out of Harry Ainley.
It's funny because when you're up here, they don't look 6'5".
No.
But when you get down on the floor, you're like, oh yeah, he's tall. Bethlehem, I would say they won the nicest panel.
Yes, they did. They have beautiful Air Jordans up in there. They're driving. Sam Bassong for a three. Yes.
Oh, there he is, folks.
All the way from Warman, Saskatchewan. That's how deep he hit that three.
At least Martinsville, I was thinking.
Martinsville.
Yeah, folks, if you got a chance, check out the Instagram page. You can see all the different panels that the teams have. Bethlehem Stars have an amazing panel.
Jacob Houston with an offensive rebound, and he puts it back to regain the lead for the Harry Ainley Titans.
I can see they haven't changed the names here. So don't be confused, folks. Bedford's not playing right now.
Sam Bassong takes it to A.J. Beatty. It's a good battle. Bethlehem with the offensive rebound. Frank drives the ball, loses it a little bit to Sam Bassong on a three.
Here he is.
Little off the backboard there. A.J. Beatty running the floor, looking for Jacob Houston. Alley-oop. Oh,
no,
just
go.
A little off. Just a little off. Sam Bassong again drives. Nice. Off the glass. Ties it up. Sam Bassong, he is the leader for the Bethlehem Stars here, folks. Bethlehem sitting in their zone. Harry Ainley looking to use that height of Jacob Houston in the middle.
So Bethlehem lost to St. George's last night. So that put them over on this side here. And just because a team is on the losing side of the bracket doesn't mean they're not going to try and win out.
No, they...
I think there's always pride.
Pride. They are playing for pride of their community. They are playing for pride of the Titans. Remember the Titans.
And every team moving forward is going to end up, well, not every team, every team that loses, right, ends up over in this bracket. So it's not an easy feat to win out on the B side,
no.
You know, consolation side.
Yes. Takia Trombone all the way from Aberdeen, Saskatchewan.
That guy's automatic.
He's automatic. Bethlehem coming out shooting the threes. Ainley
Oh, my.
Calm,
yeah, I told you.
Calm my jaw.
I don't have enough fingers. I'm not going to be able to count this high. This is going to be a high score.
We're in an old-fashioned shootout here,
not
ladies and gentlemen.
A lot of defense happening so far.
Another,
that was a long deuce there.
Another long deuce. Pavard Mahin. Harry Ainley slowing it down. Sam Bassong here.
Yeah, they really lean on him. Grade 12. Here he is.
Sam Bassong
again. Wow.
Everything goes through Sam Bassong. He drives and banks it off the backboard
again. Everything goes through him.
Yep. Bethlehem back in that zone. Harry Ainley puts Jacob Houston down in the bottom here, trying to find that. Looking deep.
Oh, a little too far there.
Little too
far. Frank Abillo.
Harry Ainley is bringing in the first three subs of the game here.
All right, more names to learn. Here we go. Owen Harris is in, and who's the other gentleman? Number 12. We got
Rayron Nang.
Rayhan Nanzi.
And Jasmine Graywall, number 4. A skip past to Jay.
You're calling a foul there?
Jasmine. Bethlehem is still sitting in their zone here. Harry Ainley trying to find the seams here.
11-8. We got it, you know. It's anybody's game.
Anybody game here. Jasmine Graywall. Keeping his dribble alive. Calm Majok from deep. Little off the mark. Bethlehem in transition.
Wide open there.
Frank with the nice layup.
Frank the Tank.
Frank Obillo.
Money in the bank.
There we go.
T for timeout.
Harry Ainley's calling a timeout. They do not like their transition defense.
Well, I have to say, we got a full house right now.
It is a full house. We have our elementary schools in here,
right,
ladies and gentlemen.
Yes, Miss Whitecalf orchestrating things from behind the scenes, checking weather reports, buses.
Everything was in consideration here.
She always makes sure to jam the gym here on Friday afternoon. Those poor seniors at Bedford, they're all sitting up in the classroom right now.
They're all in the classroom.
Make way. The next generation gets to watch a little Brit basketball.
Yes.
They could be inspiring the next, you know, MVP of Brit right
the
here.
MVP
we could
of
be
Brit.
Sitting in the midst of a future.
Yes, yes. This is full of energy, and the players are feeding off of the energy.
Oh, definitely.
Yes.
You know, I think this is what it takes sometimes, you know. You just need to one trip to Brit for a young guy or a young gal, and they might be inspired. I want to play basketball.
Yes, exactly.
You know? I was watching a documentary, and they're talking all about how the effect Wayne Gretzky had on, like, hockey in the South.
In the South.
Or Vince Carter.
Yes, in Toronto.
And they say, like, with Canada's basketball, you know, we're getting stronger on the world stage. They say it's the Vince Carter effect.
The Vince Carter effect. Yes, he did. He was changing basketball in Toronto.
Yeah, and then nationwide. Lots of kids put down the hockey stick, picked up the basketball.
Exactly.
And I'm sure the moms and dads were happy because hockey's expensive.
Just to buy a pair of shoes versus all the hockey equipment.
Well, no, I guess, yeah. Now the basketball shoes are probably worth just as much pair of skates.
Yes, yes. Okay, Harry Ainley comes out of the timeout here. Let's see what kind of adjustments that coach wanted them to make.
Down by 4. Looks like Bethlehem's playing some kind of defense.
They're playing
their arms up.
They're playing in a zone defense. Harry Ainley is settling for the
pass again, just out of Frank's reach.
Bethlehem trying to score in transition, but the Titans made some adjustments. Jacob Houston, 6'5" in the middle.
Oh, he is huge.
He is huge. Owen Harris looking for him, cutting. Jasmine Graywall, little off the mark. Harry Ainley does a better job with their transition defense here.
Hey, things tightening up after that opening, volley of shots.
Sam Bassong, an offensive rebound. Gets fouled from Owen Harris. Sam Bassong is going to the free throw line again, ladies and gentlemen.
We better. Should we give the folks a little taste here? Here we go. Hey, we got it all
Bassong
up here.
Yes.
I can't believe they gave us this much control. Somebody made a... a foolish decision. We have the ability to change camera angles up here.
All on the fly. This is for the fans at home.
Oh, you're not going to watch this later, are you?
No.
No.
I only watch live.
That'd be weird.
I only watch live.
I don't
want
to listen to myself.
Yeah.
This is a one-time thing. I want them to delete these games.
Jacob Houston with a defensive rebound. Harry Annie looking to push the
pace. What's going on with the cameraman? Hello? Is there anybody up there right now?
I think that's us.
Yeah, but it's not moving.
Number 10, Osage, kicks it to Sam Bassong.
Is the wrong camera?
Sam Bassong with the drive. Bumps into his own player. Patia Trombone with the three. Oh, nice, hits the three all the way from Osler, Saskatchewan. And that's how deep the threes are coming in today. Jazz Moon, Jacob Houston looking for it. Kaum Majok answers back with the three. This is an old-fashioned shootout, ladies and gentlemen. A three-point shooting contest is happening.
I noticed that. It's not a lot of down low in the paint. This is all from range.
This is all from the range. This is the effect of Maurice with the nice finish. Jazz Moon, Graywall with the rebound. Takam Majok looks for Jazz Moon. He's going to swing it over to Ren. Rayon Nang. Harry Ainley keeps the ball with 14 seconds.
I think we got some technical difficulties. I think the student's running the wrong camera. We're getting it sorted out.
We got it figured out.
Hey, that's what this is all about. Nobody's claiming. We're not the NBA here.
Kaum Majok again with another deep three. Patia Trombone passes it to Maurice. Number five comes up with the rebound for the Bethlehem Stars. Osage with the defense. Sam Bassong is just hustling on every play, ladies and gentlemen. He is the leader of the Bethlehem Stars. Nice passing play.
Okay, what's going on with the camera?
Nice passing play and a great finish from Jacob Houston here. Ties the game up 15-15 with 45 seconds left in the first quarter. A foul on the ground before the shot. Ball on the sidelines for the Bethlehem Stars.
I think we got her figured out. Sorry about that, Foxtrot. We had some technical difficulties above us.
We are all learning. We have our camera men and women are learning just on top there, too.
Hey, you know what? That's what I always say. This is a high school tournament. We're not the NBA. I think the audience at home is more than happy to listen to us.
To listen to us, yes.
Watch a little basketball on a cold day.
Bethlehem's keeping their dribble in the corner. Sam Bassong with another three in and out, ladies and gentlemen.
I wonder how many points he's run up already. He's got to have at least 10 of the 15.
He's got it. Yes, he's in every. He has his hand on every play.
Yeah. No, he's a talented young man.
He's in grade 12, so he's finishing off his high school career, and he wants to go out in style here at the Bedford Road Invitational Tournament.
That's right.
He knows the history of 54 years here.
Sam is well read.
Harry Ainley with another three all the way from Fort McMurray, Saskatchewan.
Where he's from?
That's how deep they're shooting from. This is us. They're shooting from deep range here. Bethlehem's going to go for the last shot of the game. Patia Trombone comes back and answers. All the way from Aberdeen, Saskatchewan.
There's got to be another town other than Aberdeen. I hated that place. I played hockey there one time. Froze my toes, man.
What you can do, I can do just as good. That is what Patia Trombone answers with the Bethlehem Stars. This is unbelievable, ladies and gentlemen.
Wow, the quality of the if you guys make it down to the game here, you got to get yourself a program. The quality of the paper.
This is
next level. You really get your money's worth, you know?
This is the next level, yes.
That'll be after the second quarter. Yeah, we're going to have. I'm excited for this.
Yep. Whoever the DJ of the tournament, they are playing good music during the game here.
I see some of the elementary schools getting loaded up here a little earlier than usual because of the cold, cold temps, folks. But don't let those cold temps stop you. If you're sitting on your butt right now in Saskatoon, you got to get down to the gym, get a dog in you, maybe some taco in a bag.
Taco in a bag, yes. The hot dogs are unreal.
Hey, I've had three now.
Three.
My record is eight.
Eight, oh. Is he going to set the record, ladies and gentlemen?
No, I don't. You know what? I don't. I'm getting older now.
He's getting old.
I'm getting a little wiser.
He's looking. He's coming for a Chester here from the hot dog eating championship.
Oh, well, we've got more tech issues coming up. I think they're coming to lay the hammer down on our camera person. Okay. The grand exodus. These kids got to make it back to school.
Got to make it back home safe and sound here.
Hey, it's icy out there.
So 18-18 after the first quarter.
Yeah.
Bethlehem.
Things slowed down a little.
Yep. But they're both are feeling the confidence of shooting the three. Let's see what Bethlehem does here. Jacob Houston with the steal to calm a jock to AJ
Beattie.
Oh, that was a nice play. A little too excited. The coach from Mary Ainley wants his players to protect the ball a little bit better. That was a two-on-one. He wanted that basket, ladies and gentlemen. Franco Billows running the point here for the Bethlehem Stars. He is icing up the defense. Seems Sam Bassong down low.
Frank and Sam sound like a 50s rock duo.
Jacob Houston picks up the foul, sending Sam Bassong to the free throw line. Sam Bassong is shooting 93% from the free throw line this weekend, ladies and gentlemen. This is a good man from the free throw line.
These numbers that you get, I don't know where you're getting them from, but it's astounding that you remember this kind of stuff. Are you a card counter? Like, you're not allowed in the casino anymore,
right? No, I am out of the casino now.
Yeah, they don't let you in.
No.
Do not take anything that Foxtrot says.
Sam Bassong.
To heart, folks.
Here we go. Let's see how Ari Ainley handles this zone. They want to find Jacob Houston on the inside in the paint.
There he is, the big man himself.
They want to use that 6'5" frame, but Bethlehem doing a pretty good job of keeping them on the perimeter.
Oh!
Sam Bassong comes up with the block. Number 6, Parker Veen.
Okay. I want to know who number 10 is because they got him scratched out. They had him labeled as Gabriel Sermet, but that's I think that was an error.
Yes. So.
For Harry Ainley. Or no, wait a minute. That's on Beth.
Yep.
Yeah, number 10.
Osazi Osagle. He is not.
Yeah, he's pretty good on defense.
Yeah, he's 6'6" himself.
Oh, so these guys are huge. What are they feeding him?
There's Franco Billo finding Sam Bassong again. Gets fouled, ladies and gentlemen.
I'm going to keep a tally of how many times we say his name.
Sam Bassong.
I'll burn through a pencil.
We are at 21 times in this game. 21 times we have said Sam Bassong. Sam Bassong hits another
swish
one from the free throw line, yes.
All them darn kids leaving their pop cans behind.
Harry Ainley sends out a couple of players deep, trying to spread the floor, get a little bit space for Tom Majok to bring the ball up. Harry Ainley is trying to figure out how to get inside of this zone to get to Jacob Houston. There they find him. That's what they want. He gets fouled.
Yeah. And you know, it's a 10-on-10 matchup there because Osage's got, I think he's tagged with keeping an eye on Houston.
Yeah, 6'6" versus 6'5". That is going to be an interesting battle. Who can stay out of foul trouble is going to be.
And I often wonder, you know, like when the coaches submit their data for the book, their height and stuff, are they kind of grab a couple inches? Like, are these guys.
Are they standing on their toes? That's
right.
Yes.
I mean, I don't think these guys got to worry about trying to, like, steal an inch or two. They're pretty tall guys.
Jacob Houston makes the first one, ladies and gentlemen. Jacob Houston makes the second one.
Okay.
Franco Billo is bringing up the ball for the Bethlehem Stars, and Calm Majok picks him up full court. Let's see how they handle the pressure with the one-on-one game here. Joma from Bethlehem swings it out to Patia Trombone, gets the screen. Osaji, they wanted to get back to him, but Sam Bassong saves it. Just loses control. The Hanley Titans are having a little bit of trouble getting the ball to Jacob Houston because of Osage's height.
There he is.
There it is. Oh, he traveled a little bit.
Bags were packed. I wonder where he was going.
Oh.
Away from here.
Jacob Houston thought it was deflected, and that's why he did not think it was a travel. Okay, Harry Ainley's picking up a full court press here, trying to switch up the defense.
That's what that's called.
Bring some energy. They're bringing energy with the defense.
We've got Britt Chair, Nicole Poyer manning the score table. Nice to see
Herbie. Bethlehem Joma drives. Oh, what a tough basket, and he's feeling it. That gave him some confidence, ladies and gentlemen.
It's good to see Miss Poyer recognized for her years and years of dedication to Britt. Now moved on to Aiden Bowman across the river.
Yeah.
Different time zone over there.
And it's very fitting that the Aiden Bowman Bears are in here, right?
Last minute.
And it's the last minute.
They snuck in this morning and put a panel up.
Yes, they have
saw
a beautiful
saw that in the
panel.
Corner. Of course, one of the teams from Spruce Grove, Alberta, too cold for their buses to run yesterday.
Yes.
So sadly, they had to late cancellation. But in typical Brit fashion, managed to scramble together. I mean, teams are just itching to get invited. You know, this is like the party everybody wants
this
to come to.
This is what everybody wants.
You know, so I don't think she had to twist many arms.
Nope.
Miss Kim Garner and company.
Harry Inley's going to run a standard box here off the inbounds. Looking for Jacob Houston with the three. Boom.
Oh, boy.
He nails
it. Oh, boy.
All the way.
Not much of a...
From the downtown Calgary area. That's how deep he is shooting.
Yeah, that was definitely inner city.
Sam Bassong drives again and gets fouled. He's at the...
The old charity stripe here for Sammy boy.
This is his fourth time there in this quarter alone.
Okay,
Sam Bassong.
All knotted up here.
23-23, 5 minutes left in the quarter. Sam misses the first one, which is a rare miss here.
Yeah, you know, I'm always fascinated. The tempo of the games, because they're a shorter quarter, you know, you can kind of go, kind of play your bench a little quicker. You don't maybe have to dig deep into the bench.
But your stars can stay in the game a little bit longer.
Well, yeah, and I mean, because you don't want to fall too far behind, though, because, you know, the clocks tick quick here.
Number eight. Akon Deng tried to force that pass, but he forgot the rim was in the vicinity.
wrong way.
Yeah,
you can't go from the bottom.
Rim.
You got to go
did
top
not
down.
See the right. rim.
Top down.
Harry Ainley is going to run X here, I think, here.
X. Always a big play. One of my faves.
Owen Harris comes in for AJ Beattie. X, they called it right there. That's what they wanted. To Akon Deng to number three.
Ooh, I like X.
Allen Tan, X.
X works.
Yes. The Marvel comic was in play here at Bedford.
Oh, my. Couldn't get it to go.
Sam Bassong with the drive. Off the backboard a little too strong. And Jacob Houston with another defensive rebound.
Jacob Houston just calm.
He's calm and cool.
Calm, cool, collected. Yeah.
He has been in these situations many, many years.
He's got the basketball player build.
He's got
the,
yes. And he drives, and look at that nice finish.
You know, some of these kids are definitely multi-sport athletes, and I'm not saying that Houston isn't, but he definitely has the look of, I mean, he could be a receiver for a football team too, but real basketball player look to him.
Yep.
And here he is.
Owen Harris with the defensive rebound. Jasmine Graywall.
Okay. Number six last name on Beth is not Trombone, man.
Oh, it's Trombe.
It's Trombe. Hey,
thank you.
Trombe.
Trombe. I will correct Trombe that.
Trombe like Bombay, baby.
Thank you very much.
We like that. Yes. Keep it up. I love being corrected. I'm used to it.
Bethlehem Stars with the timeout. Coach wants to stop this little run that Harry Ainley's on. It's 31-24.
You know, I think this is a good time to maybe give a shout out to some of these amazing sponsors that we have, you know? Like Laser Autobody.
Laser Autobody.
Oh, they're probably getting tons of business if it's so icy out there.
It has to
you
be.
You know? Trail Appliance. Why buy from Trail? Because they got thousands of items. That's why.
Yep.
What else we got? Culligan Water.
Culligan Water.
Keeping these gentlemen and the ladies hydrated. Oh, the Rattlers.
They were here for the pep rally. That was great. Great
the
to
mascot
see.
Shook
the
his hand.
The mascot. Oh, my God.
I didn't think snakes had hands.
Nice. Oh, holy.
Yeah. Sastel, of course, providing all that Wi-Fi.
All about the Wi-Fi, and this is for our
Rolco Radio.
Rolco Radio.
Love them.
54 years of Brit. This is how prestigious all of these community sponsors are.
We even got shout-outs to, like, Brad Redekop. Best wishes to the participants of the 2024 Bedford Road Invitational Tournament. Bring it home, says Brad. Of course, Old Dutch Chips.
Old Dutch Chips.
Ham Construction, Rock Creek, Flavors Catering. The list goes on. We salute all of those, local businesses and businesses helping us out here at Brit 54, baby.
Patea Tom Bay is bringing up the ball.
There we go, Tom Bay.
He's looking for that nice pick and roll there. Oh, to Osaji, nice finish.
No dice.
There's no dice, just a little strong. Way to come out with the pick and roll. The pick and roll is one of the most effective plays in basketball, but is also the most underrated.
That's the one I use when I want to get boogers out of my nose.
Right there.
The pick and then I roll it.
The pick and the roll.
Flick it out the window if I'm driving. Or
Jacob Houston with the rebound.
Tom Bay gets it off there.
Joma he's running in transition, drives, floater, and gets the nice roll.
Ainley turning on the heat here near the end of the first half. 3 minutes to go.
Bethlehem is locking up their defense. This is what they want to do, exactly, forcing an out of bounds with a deflection.
All right, Bassong got a touch on that. I think it should be.
It is Harry Ainley's ball still, yep.
Harry Ainley ball, blue ball.
Let's see what they run.
So I don't know if you've been watching, but have you noticed any sneakers that are really jumping out at you this tournament? Is there anybody that's wearing any particular ones? Because we usually try to give a shout-out to the nice kicks of the tournament, eh? From way back, no dice.
Jazz Moon, Graywall, Owen Harris tries a three.
Number two there.
Number
Aranda.
Two, Maurice Aranda.
My kind of guy. He's like Spud Webb out there.
Sam Bassong. Jasmine Graywall in transition to Owen Harris. Back to Jasmine Graywall, number seven, Gavin Make. Owen Harris with 10 on the shot clock. Let's see what they do. Jacob Houston.
Yep. Trying to get it to the big man there.
Maurice Aranda, what a hustle play and a flip. And he landed on his
feet. Are we going to get a dunk? Sometimes I got to be ready for that. And you can.
Yeah.
I didn't want to do it, though. I was a little nervous.
Bethlehem, number five, is feeling confidence. He has the last couple baskets here.
Yeah, Jaquino.
Owen Harris with a deep three. He's off the mark. Sam Bassong with a defensive rebound to Osaji in transition. Kicks it back out to Maurice. Bethlehem's going to slow it down. Let's see what they run here. Looking for that pick and roll with Sam Bassong. Yes, what they wanted. And
you called it. That's money.
Sam Bassong with a beautiful finish off the pick and roll.
Yep, they're within one here with a little over a minute and a half, folks.
This zone is causing Harry Ainley a little bit of troubles, but they're looking for Jacob Houston, their big man. Osaji blocks it.
Kind of forced that one, I think.
Yeah.
Got timeout? What's going on here? Nope. Okay, a little confusion.
Little confusion of who got that out of bounds, but it's Harry Ainley's ball. Jacob Houston is going to take a little breather for A.J. Beattie.
Okay.
Number 12, Rayhan Nang comes in as well. Sam Bassong again, ladies and gentlemen, with the defensive stop. Yoma from Bethlehem. Osaji drives off the mark. Osaji is looking to take advantage of Jacob Houston on the bench, ladies and gentlemen.
That was impressive hand-eye coordination there. The way he just, like, laser beam, you know. He just
Let's see what Bethlehem runs under there, looking like a stack. No, they're going back to their box for a formation. Frank Obillo here, swinging around to Patia Tombone, just a little off the mark. Gavin Mack dribbles it up to Calm Majok. Gavin Make here, looking for AJ Beatty, trying to find the seams in that zone. Calm Majok, oh, what a deep three.
Wow.
All the way from Edmonton, Alberta.
I can see why my parents named him Calm. He stays calm.
He's calm, ladies and gentlemen. 50 seconds left here. Let's see what Bethlehem with the no-look pass to Sam Bassong. Frank Obillo with a beautiful no-look pass from a cutting Frank Bassong.
Okay, we got ourselves a timeout here, folks. Woo-wee.
34-30-32. The score tables are really having to earn their hot dogs today because both coaches are watching the scoreboard, making sure there are no mistakes.
None.
But I just want to give a big shout out to our Brit team as they are down there giving their best. This is a little bit younger team on the scoreboards, but they're doing a phenomenal job.
You know, and that's kind of the way it works. The years I've been here, you kind of see the kids cycle through. If we can get them hooked on score table by grade 9 or 10, get involved a little bit. And then by grade 12, we've churned out. Oh, are we going to be running an interview here?
And just at the halftime.
Oh,
here.
Yeah, yep. That's our halftime interview, yeah. We're bringing everything this year. This is new. We got the halftime interview. When I first started, I sound like an old man now, but I'm telling you, we have one camera. Well, no, that's a lie. We did have a backboard cam on the one end.
On the one end.
Yeah. So, you know.
How many Brits have you been in?
Well, since I started at the school, this will be my 12th.
12 Brits. There you heard it, folks.
I'm 12 deep.
12 deep. He is experienced. Okay, Harry Ainley, let's see what they drew up coming out of the timeout.
45 seconds.
They
lots
have 45
of time
seconds.
Here.
Coach is going to take a quick shot. He probably wants a 2-for-1 because there's going to be a quick shot. And there it is. AJ Beatty to Calm Majok, but no.
Oh,
number
my.
Five from Bethlehem
Great
again.
Hands.
Bethlehem, number five, Joel
Majokino.
He is feeling the confidence here. AJ Beatty looking for Jacob Houston.
Starting to see Aiden Bowman.
Ray Hahn with the nice deep three. Extends the lead to three. Bethlehem going for the last shot of the half here. Patia Tomboy looking with the pick and roll game. Osage.
Okay, folks.
What a game we have here. 37-34.
37-34. And what are we going to be treated to for the halftime show there, Foxtrot? We got a little Bedford Bhangra crew.
Bhangra crew.
And the Venom.
The Venom Dance
team. Okay. And I'm seeing some local fans filing in because after this game, we've got the, I believe it's Aiden Bowman is playing.
Yes, I also believe it is.
Yeah, right here. I think we got it right here. Yeah, Aiden Bowman is taking on
the defending champs.
These
Raymond
guys play
Comets.
Raymond.
Raymond.
I was told. Now this, I met Raymond's probably tuning in. Some families from Raymond. But I was told. We were on the mics last year. Famous Amos and Rick Ricochet, who's over in Australia on a holiday, taking a year away from teaching. We were told if we ever roll through Raymond and we run out of gas, they'll point us in the direction of the gas station.
Hey, that is good.
You know?
That
is good. We were talking up those young players so well, they said, hey, the gas station's that way.
Holy.
So we'll be rolling out the red carpet.
The red carpet.
Yeah. Well, the great group of boys that came. I'm sure there's going to be plenty of action. They'll serve up a show.
They will serve up a show. And
I don't know. Bowman better bring their A game. But we're going to let you listen to the sounds of the gym, folks. Halftime, 37. Harry Ainley out of Edmonton, Alberta against the local Bethlehem Stars, 34. Thank you.
Jimo Jokino.
Yeah. How do you think you played in the first half?
The first half, I could have done better, but like, right now, I'm pretty sure I think I'm doing pretty good.
Yeah, so do you think you guys are going to win in the second half here?
Yes, honestly. We talked about it a little bit. I think we can do better and honestly beat these guys.
Yeah. So what do you think your strengths are on the team?
We have good shooters, people who can push the ball in transition and all of that.
Yeah, sounds good. So how do you guys think you're going to do in Brit and like the whole Brit?
I think that we can place like top four or three, third or fourth, honestly.
Sounds good, yeah. Well, thank you. That's about it. Yeah.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. We are back here to start the second half. It is 37-34 for the Ainley Titans over the Bethlehem Stars with lots of basketball to play. Harry Ainley is trying to find the ball on the inside to the big man, Jacob Houston. But the Bethlehem Stars are doing a great job of keeping the ball on the perimeter. Calm Majok has to settle for the baseline jumper. Number five, Joma, is feeling it around the back. Little too much confidence as he just lost it, though. That's okay. He gains his composure. Sam Bassong with the reverse layup over A.J. Beatty. Sam Bassong is the leader for the Bethlehem Stars here. Number 10, Bethlehem picks up the foul on Jacob Houston. Osagie from the Bethlehem Stars. Body language shows he didn't really like the call. Jacob Houston with the three. Just a little off the mark. A.J. Beatty with an offensive rebound for the Harry Ainley Titans, who settle it back down. Bethlehem Stars doing a really good job of keeping them on the perimeter. Jacob Houston with the shot from the baseline. Sam Bassong with another defensive rebound. Franco Billo. Sam Bassong down low. Just off the mark. Calm Majok slowly brings up the ball. Harry Ainley sizing up the defense, looking where, there it is. Jacob Houston with the dunk. Ladies and gentlemen, Harry Ainley come to play in the second half, and Jacob Houston is leading the charge. Patea, Tombe with the offensive rebound, and he scores. Cuts the lead back to one here. Jacob Houston got a little excited. He wanted that baseline, but he was called for the travel. Harry Ainley gonna go back into their full court man press here. Bethlehem Stars are just walking it up. They're looking for the pick and roll game here, just a little off the mark though. Bethlehem Stars wanted that possession back. Thank you very much, the Brisk, here we go. Special sponsors here.
Some form of lemon.
AJ Beattie getting the ball onto the outside to, right. Owen Harris, to Jacob Houston down low. Harry Ainley's doing a little bit job of swinging the ball quicker. Jacob Houston.
There he is again.
Sam Bassong with another defensive rebound, drives it. Gets called for the charge.
Okay, so there was no halftime show.
There was no halftime show. There was a mix-up in the schedule, but that's okay.
It happens.
It happens. We just roll with it. Sam Bassong with the charge. Ethan Barton steps in and takes that for his team, and his bench loves it. Calm Majok shoots the three. Little off the mark. Out of bounds, Bethlehem Stars ball.
Starting to see some more local fans filing in here.
Yep.
Aiden Bowman taking on defending champion Raymond out of Raymond, Alberta.
That's going to be a great matchup.
Aiden Bowman, a late addition.
Late addition. They are going to be firing just on adrenaline of being a last-minute replacement.
Pretty excited.
Yep.
They better tie their shoes because Raymond plays fast.
Fast and shoots well. AJ Beattie with the defensive rebound.
Oh,
and
my.
Harry Ainley wanted to push that quick. Little too high of a pass to catch, though.
It's between his fingertips there. It's out of his grasp.
for the Harry Ainley Titans.
I quite like Harry Ainley's panel.
Yes.
Like the giant. It's kind of a cool idea.
Yep. Sam Bassong.
Has that guy been off the court?
I don't think he's been off the court yet, folks.
He's like the Energizer Bunny, man.
He is the Energizer. Osage saves
there he is
the ball.
Again.
Osage saves the ball for the Bethlehem Stars to Frank.
You know, I think of all the players that we've seen play in this tournament, I think Sam Bassong is probably the most utilized of any team. Like, you know, like you said, everything goes through Sam.
Yep.
Everything.
But he also leads it on the defensive side, too.
Yeah, like he's not just one-dimensional.
No. Bethlehem setting up for an inbound play. Let's see if it goes to Sam Bassong.
I'm going to put my money on it.
I'm going to put a money on it here. We have a little wager. Let's see.
A little friendly wager.
Wow, it goes to him. Unbelievable.
I'm rich.
This guy is rich. Oh.
I don't think the odds makers are paying out much on that one.
Sam Bassong.
And then I think at the halftime show in the next game, we fire up the 3-on-3 tournament again.
Yep.
That's always exciting.
Semifinals.
Yeah, because I know that Aiden Bowman was playing last night. They knocked off the local hosts here, the Bedford Road.
The Bedford Red Hawk team.
Yeah, the juniors. Because I teach those kids in period one.
Oh, so they're devastated.
They didn't even come. A couple of them didn't even show up.
They didn't even show
up. So cold, they just stayed home.
That's how much pride is in that 3-on-3 tournament.
Seriously, yeah. There's swag up for grabs, you know?
There was a foul called on Harry Ainley.
Okay. Some form of infraction.
It wasn't a shooting foul, so the ball is on the baseline here. Bethlehem is going to number 5, Juma. Juma has been having the hot hand in the first half, so
Juma. He was interviewed at halftime.
Juma was interviewed
there.
At
he
halftime.
He was the halftime entertainer.
Yep.
Oh, Sam.
Jacob
hits
Houston gets called for the foul on Sam.
Pasong doesn't
want any. It was out of bounds, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, he didn't want any of that help up. He's a little frustrated with number 10 there. He's having a few words. Okay, I always like to read lips. I can't repeat what I heard.
Bethlehem.
One of my many skills.
One of the many skills. Bethlehem Stars are sitting in their zone here. Kamajok drives, kicks it.
That's number four.
Jasmine Graywall loses control. Yes. That's that is okay. He's gonna learn. He has a bright future ahead of him.
He's at school. He's gonna learn.
Yep. This is what it's all about, the learning game here. Osagie, what long strides. Bethlehem keeps the possession.
We got ourselves a 1-point game, folks.
A 1-point game.
Halfway through the third quarter.
Sam Bassong wants it, but Owen Harris tries to guard him. Oh, Sam Bassong takes it to the...
Is this going to be a record for individual points in a game?
To the Harry Ainley defense. Sam Bassong came to a play, ladies and gentlemen. He is on fire. Harry Ainley looking to answer.
Nice pass.
Sam.
Watch out.
Out of bounds with 4 seconds left on the shot clock. This is going to have to be a quick little play.
Yeah. Yeah. Never get, you know.
Look for Jacob Houston to get the shot off over the mismatch that he has with Maurice Oranda on him.
Okay.
On the three.
That's
Jacob Houston,
eh?
Right over Maurice Oranda. Exactly what we've seen. And he almost made it, but Maurice made him shoot a difficult shot.
You know, that was just enough to disrupt the
just
flow
enough,
there.
Yes.
Just enough.
Maurice Oranda is a force on defense, ladies and gentlemen. He is not scared of the big man. He loves the challenge.
Maurice rocking in at they listed him at
5'6".
Even I got a couple inches on Maurice. On a good day, I've stretched.
Good
have
day
the spine
stretch.
Stretched. Yes. And hang upside down like a bat. Okay, 318.
Let's see if they run X.
Nope. I like X. You introduced me to X. Now this
Owen
is
Harris with the deep three, a little strong.
No go.
Pita Tombe with the defensive rebound.
Juma
here.
Our boy.
He's feeling it in the first half. Coach is trusting him, and he's rewarding him. There's a little miscommunication on Bethlehem Stars. They were trying to run a pick and roll, but the roll did not come.
The roll, no roll.
Jacob
all
Houston to
roll.
Number six.
Oh, my. That was nice.
Deep three ties this game 42-42 with less than 3 minutes left in the third quarter. Sam Bassong, he knew that right away. He was backing up
this
as soon as it left his hand.
I know. He knew it was in.
As soon as he left
touch.
His hand, yeah. He was backing up. He was going to play defense. Harry Ainley is moving the ball on the perimeter pretty quick. Jasmine Graywall.
Oh, he's fallen into
he
his zone. That's two in a row.
He comes himself.
Okay, we're getting ourselves. This was similar to how the game started.
This is what the
you
fans
know, they were
want.
The lights out there early on.
This is what the fans want is offense, but I guarantee you the coaches want a stop on defense.
I think the fans want a Brit Dog.
They want
they just
a Brit
don't
Dog.
Miss out
yes.
On the game.
Come on down, folks, to the Brit Dogs. They are legendary. Patia Trombone deep.
It's Tom Bay.
Tom Bay. Tom Bay. Rayhan Nang with the three, a little off the mark. And big man Maurice Oranda with the defensive rebound. Rayhan Nang steps in and takes the charge on Maurice Oranda. Maurice Oranda is so quick that he couldn't stop in time.
Yeah.
And Rayhan knew that, so he just planted himself and took the charge.
He was into a different dimension there.
That was quickness, and that was taking one for the team. 149 left, 45-45.
Stars have some form of defense out here.
It's a 2-3
zone. It's a 2-3.
Yes.
That's what that is.
They are going to look for that backdoor cut to Akon Dang. Akon Dang is running the baseline here, ladies and gentlemen. He's trying to find a seam right there. Kicks it out to Calm Majok, who's looking to swing to Jasmine Graywall. Number six.
Couldn't get it to
Couldn't
drop.
Get it. Jacob Houston gets the rebound, though. Jacob Houston
he cleans up. Yeah, you give that guy some Windex, he'll clean the glass all day.
Oh, he is eating up the rebounds. Number eight, Akon Dang drives, floats in the air, little off the mark.
Little. But you know what? That's okay.
That's okay.
I've been off the mark plenty.
Bethlehem's number five, Juma with the foul.
Okay.
Juma was not going to give him an easy basket. He's
nope.
going to make him earn him from the free
Game's
throw line.
Far too tight for easy baskets.
Yep.
We don't do easy baskets at Britt.
Here we go. Akon Dang. There's.
Nails his first from the charity stripe
his
there.
His first from the charity stripe. That is his first free throw line in the tournament. Akon Dang hits them both. Spreads this lead to 4 points. Sam DeSong gonna bring up the ball. They're calling Horns. Horns a double screen on the guard. Let's see where the roll comes into. Osagie, but Sam DeSong.
Uncharacteristic.
Forced up a shot. Maurice Oronda with the steal to Juma, number five again, ladies and gentlemen.
Juma Chokino.
Juma is leading the charge for the Bethlehem Stars.
Yeah, filling in there.
He's filling in. Number seven, Gavin Make. Osagie with the rebound.
Here we
to
go.
Guess who? Sam Besong. He's looking for the cutter.
Long.
Patia Tombe. Just off the mark.
He was shooting. That was from a different postal code.
Jasmine Graywall. Akon Dang. That's who Ari Hanley's looking for on the baseline. And they find him. And he hits that baseline shot, ladies and gentlemen. That is his money spot. He
Very
loves it
so.
On the baseline.
Okay, folks.
Akon Dang loves his shot on the baseline. He takes 87% of his shots from the baseline. Let's see if they were going to keep on capitalizing in the fourth quarter.
Well, you never know. I mean, that's a pretty accurate number that you threw out, that 87%. I'm very impressed you remember that kind of stuff. We got Harry Ainley out of Edmonton up by four on the Bethlehem Stars, folks. We'll let you listen to the sounds of the gym as we roll into the final quarter. Anybody's game at this stage. Who's climbing up there?
Who's climbing up there?
Grab you an SD out of the coach's cooler.
Heck yeah. Let's go.
We have to try and get that on the dunk. Kid from St. George from something.
Yeah,
exciting.
Yeah.
All right, folks, we're back. Fourth quarter action here on the B side. After this game, if you're tuning in early, I know some folks from Raymond are probably tuning in. They didn't make the drive.
Didn't make the drive.
Old
this
Uncle
weather.
Tom, yep. Maybe Grandma Sally. They'll be kicking off after this. Raymond will be taking on the local Aiden Bowman Bears. But before that, we got that fourth quarter action here.
Oh, what a ball!
Oh, you did
Unbelievable.
It.
Unbelievable.
Foxtrot with that fancy camera angle.
That was a block. That's the block of the tournament. The crowd went wild. Sam Bassong again with the offensive rebound. That's how the team wants to play. Defense goes to offense.
That's right. Transition. I know what that means. Boom. I use them in my essays when I teach them.
Jacob Houston with the shot, just a little off. Patea, Tom Bay to Franco Billo, who drives, takes it to Jacob Houston, but no.
No go.
Jacob Houston, 6'5" frame, is a little intimidating in the paint.
He's big.
He's big, ladies and gentlemen, here. Calm Majok looking for Akon Ding on the baseline, but Bethlehem Stars are making their adjustments to cut off that baseline pass. But again, they find him.
They do.
Akon Dang again from the baseline, ladies and gentlemen.
87% of it. Might be up to 89 now.
89% of his shots are taken from the baseline.
We have a statistician. We have a wonder kid. Rain Man up here.
Rain Man. There we go. Osaji says, you can do that. I can do this. Calm Majaw calmly slows it down. They're looking for Jacob Houston here.
On the horn here.
Jacob Houston wants the ball to swing over here so he can make a little cut to the basket, but Calm Majok had other ideas and he settled for that three.
Okay. Same foot out of bounds there?
I think it's a kick ball, so Harry Ainley ball.
Hey, kick ball, yeah. Like.
Akon Ding takes a well-deserved rest, and Calm Majok. It's going to take a little breather. I have a feeling both of these guys are going to finish the game. So this
Yeah, they'll be back in with 6:09 for sure. Yeah.
Jacob Houston with the three.
No
little
go.
Little off the mark, and A.J. Beattie and Owen Harris.
Aranda.
Tried to get that defense offensive rebound. Franco Billo here. Patea Tombe has possession. He wants to shoot it, ladies and gentlemen. Sam Bassong, Osaji. To Patea Tombe, ladies and gentlemen, in and out.
No go.
Harry Ainley looking to pick up the pace. They do not want this zone to set up.
I'm noticing that the tempo's just kind of just picked up a little here.
It has picked
like
up.
My heart rate after that caffeine blast I had. No brand dropping here, but it's a caffeinated beverage.
Both teams know what is on the line. Jacob Houston, ladies and gentlemen, with the tough basket.
And what is on the line right now? I'd like to know.
What is on the line? Unfortunately, the
Houston's on the line.
Houston is on the line. Unfortunately, whoever loses this game is out of the tournament.
I think they get to play one more. You know, because they're guaranteed three. So right now, Bethlehem, so this is the sixth game. So L6 will move up here.
Oh, yes.
They'll play tomorrow evening. Tomorrow morning.
Tomorrow morning at 8 a.m.
Part of that red eye.
Yes.
Yes. They will be taking on the host, Bedford Road Redhawks.
Jacob Houston hits the old-fashioned three-point play. That is how the game has changed from 1976 to 2024, ladies and gentlemen. People are forgetting that an old-fashioned three-point play is 3 points still.
I'm not one for math, but even I know that one.
Harry Ainley is trying to find their sweet spot on the baseline, but.
So the loser of this game will play tomorrow morning at 8 a.m. The winner will play tomorrow at 9:15. So they get a bit of a sleep in.
A little bit of a
reward for winning. They get to sleep in before they got to head back to wherever they're from.
Seven on the shot clock here. Drive. Jasmine Graywall. Osaji changes that shot. And Jacob Houston takes off. He gets to the offensive rebound.
Again.
Again. He gets fouled, ladies and gentlemen. Jacob Houston is shooting 92% from the free throw line here for the weekend, ladies and gentlemen.
Again, these stats are not verified, so please do not quote any of this information.
Unofficial, and he just hits it again. Extends the lead to 6 points here. Sam Beattie takes drive.
We need that cameraman to give us less bleacher and more court.
That is what Sam Bassong does. He takes control of the game for the Bethlehem Stars. He drives and gets fouled. That's what he wanted, to give his team a little bit of confidence from the free throw line. A little bit of breather to slow down the tempo of the Harry Ainley Titans. Harry Ainley Titans spreading out the floor, sending two of their players deep here. Sam Bassong on the free throw line. Sam Bassong hits the first one. Cuts this lead to five with 4:42 left. Sam Bassong just hits them both, exactly what he wanted. Get a little bit of confidence from the free throw line. Let's see how Bethlehem answers here. Harry Ainley is looking for the ball on the base, on the baseline. Franco Billo bringing up the ball for the Bethlehem Stars to Tia Tom Bay, who drives baseline, posts up, fades away. That's a tough shot, but Osaji picks up the offensive rebound. Puts it over Jacob Houston, cuts this game to two points. Harry Ainley looking to swing, trying to find it on the baseline. Owen Harris pops out, just a little short. Juma with the nice defensive rebound. Sam Bassong takes the ball. He's feeling confidence. Osaji kicks it out to Frank. Frank drives. Patia settles for the three and a little long, but Jacob Houston takes the care of business on the defensive side. Owen Harris looking to the swing on top. Harry Ainley. Sam Bassong hits the floor. Doesn't come up with it. Jacob Houston hits the three. Little long though. Offensive rebound for Harry Ainley again. And they make them pay. Two offensive rebounds on that possession. Then finally Harry Ainley makes them pay. Sam Bassong shoots the three, a little long. Jacob Houston with the defensive rebound. Jasmine Graywall slowly bringing it up. Number six. A.J. Beattie wants to look for Owen Harris on the baseline. There, number six from Harry Ainley fires, drills it. That was a big shot for Harry Ainley Titans, and the bench is going wild.
I think am I back?
You're back.
I'm back, baby.
It's back.
Apologize. Mike was dead. We had a shaky cameraman up
shaky
there.
Shaky cameraman.
Shaky Graves up top. He's a little too much bleacher, not enough court.
That's
trying to get these young folk to... you know, follow protocol, damn it. We trained this for 6 weeks.
For 6 weeks. That's how nervous this game is. The cameraman is shaking.
And this is the B-side, folks.
This
you wait. We're going to jump back over to the A-side. This next matchup, we're going to have the local Aiden Bowman, collegiate.
Huh? You got to go to the bathroom? Yeah, okay, I'll go film.
Bethlehem is 57, Harry Ainley is 65, with 2 minutes and 41 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Hello, Kim.
Hi.
Long, how's it going?
You got a newbie.
We have a newbie to finish the game, ladies and gentlemen. Kim comes in clutch.
Yes. This has been quite the exciting game.
This is a very exciting game.
Yeah, it's very close.
This is a back and forth battle. Sam Bassong versus Jacob Houston. They are two leaders of the team. And right now, Jacob Houston has a little lead for his team, 65-57.
I knew yesterday we'd be talking about Sam a lot. Man, oh, he's a strong player.
He is all around. He is a leader for the Bethlehem Stars. Plays with confidence. Coach trusts him with the ball on both ends. And there's Sam Bassong. Gets to his spot. calmly knocks it down. Calm, calm Majok with the Harry Angley Titans looking to get the ball on the baseline. Akon Deng is back. So let's see how they utilize that. Sam Bassong again with the ball. He's keeping his dribble alive, drives baseline, fumbles a little bit.
Appears to be a foul.
A foul on Sam Bassong.
You know, they're pretty intense right now. 2 minutes remaining. Fifth foul.
Sam Bassong got called for his fifth foul, ladies and gentlemen. Bethlehem calls a timeout. They want to organize here to finish the game without Sam Bassong. That is going to be an uphill battle. Let's see if they are ready for it.
This would be interesting what they strategize with Sam not being in there. He's such a force.
See what the game plan is now. Let's see how Harry Ainley handles this game without Sam Bassong. 65-59.
Oh man, it's tight. 2 minutes left, a lot can happen.
A lot can happen in high school basketball. Emotions are gonna be running high. Bethlehem comes out of the timeout, ready to go. Sitting in their 2-3 zone. Let's see if Harry Ainley wants to utilize the time a little bit, or if they're going to get off some quick shots without their leader Sam Bassong and take advantage.
All right, Stars look like they're ready to defend. They're
Akon Deng will take his standard spot on the baseline. That is what the Harry Ainley Titans are looking for. They're looking for Akon Deng on the baseline. Nothing there. Let's see if they can reverse it. Number six from Harry Ainley. Little long. Akon Deng with the rebound. They got a full reset. 24 seconds back on the shot clock. AJ Beattie with the baseline. There was no shot. It was an air ball.
I know the players are getting really active on
the players are
there.
Confused, but the refs were on the ball and they call that a shot clock violation.
Oh, the coach is not happy with
the coach
their
is not happy, but we have to remember, ladies and gentlemen, we are just learning this game. Our score tables are taking pride in their job just as much as the players. Osagie with the reach over.
All right, they're getting yelled at from their coaches. We're in crunch time.
Last final instructions here. Let's see what Bethlehem comes out of the sideline play here. Number five, Juma, was leading the charge in the first half. Let's see if he's continuing to lead the charge. Yes, they come back to him. He drives it. Euro step and one.
And it counts.
What a basket, Juma. Oh, nice. He was leading the charge when Sam Bassong was not, and he continues to lead the charge.
This is awesome. Minute 39, 4-point spread. That's not bad.
4-point spread. Juma from the Bethlehem Stars is going to take over and lead his team in the final minute 39 of the game. Juma hits it, completes the three-point play. It's a three-point game with a minute 36 left. Calm Majok getting feeling a little bit of pressure, but kicks it off to AJ Beattie. And there is Maurice to Juma, who finishes the tough basket. Juma continues to lead it for the Bethlehem Stars.
One
cuts
point.
This game to one.
Oh, 1 point.
And there's Maurice pressuring AJ Beattie, forcing him to make a decision.
They're battling.
Akon Deng gets fouled. The ball is on the ground. 1 minute, 7 seconds left. What a finish we have here, ladies and gentlemen.
Foul number eight, Leon Gonzalez.
Timeout.
Oh, timeout.
Timeout, Harry Ainley. Timeout, Harry Ainley. They have the ball on the baseline. The coach wants to draw up some one little play, but I'm sure he's giving instructions what he wants to do on the defensive side,
oh
too.
Oh, my. That was quite the technical difficulties up there, folks. Whew.
Technical difficulties.
Putting out fires and taking names. That's why they call me Famous Amos.
Famous Amos this year. He is doing it all, ladies and gentlemen.
Everything.
Commentating, everything. Cameraman.
Sipping on a cola.
Sipping on a cola sponsored by Pepsi here. Pepsi.
Oh, I don't think we are. I think it's just some unnamed black substance in a can with cola and carbonation.
This is what the crowd wanted here. We are
65,
now up.
65-64. This is what I missed. Okay, we had some camera stuff going on up there. I had to crash course training session.
Training cameraman 101.
And then cameraman had to go to the washroom.
The washroom, ladies and gentlemen. The refs. The refs are making their final instructions to themselves here, trying to pay attention to all the details.
I'm actually searching the crowd for the next cameraman.
The next cameraman.
I'm wondering if he's going to make it, if it's so cold. We might need to pick somebody out of the crowd. If you have any camera skills and you're listening,
camera
you got about
skills.
15 minutes. Get your butt down here. We'll buy you a Brit Dog and a Dilly Bar.
Dilly Bar. There you heard it. Let's see if Harry Ainley comes out with something new in this offense play here. Or
question.
If they're going to go back to their confident play.
Did our boy get fouled out?
We had lost Sam Bassong.
Sam Bassong is no longer with us. He's with us, folks. Don't get worried. But Sam is currently fouled out.
He's
been fouled out for a while?
Jacob, he fouled out at a minute.
This is old news.
Yes.
Okay, so I'm just getting brought up to speed here with a minute.
Oh, Bethlehem was ready for that play to number six, the shooter from Harry Ainley. Maurice Aranda picks up the foul. They send them to the bonus.
I think we're going to queue up an all-female game here coming up next. We're going to have the Linsanity.
Linsanity
and the Long Shot are going to call this next one.
What a...
Foxtrot and Famous Amos are going to step aside. Although we've got Ripple Chips or whatever this guy goes by. He's always hanging on to get...
He's on standby, ladies
and gentlemen. He's going to have to get in line.
Number six from Harry Ainley. Makes this a two-point game. And Juma from Bethlehem with
Juma, the Puma.
He is still a force out there, too.
He is a force, like Mother Nature herself.
Number eight, Leanne Gonzalez misses that three.
That could be costly,
That's
folks.
Costly.
Moving forward, losing points. I think at this stage you want more buckets than the other team.
And Harry Ainley is in calm, cool control.
Well, this is a vital two here.
That's an offensive rebound.
Wow, what a pass, a laser beam.
Akon Dang with the Euro. What Woo! A finish from Akon Dang.
That could be the death knell there. There's plenty of time, but 29.9.
Akon Dang with the Euro finish. But that was all generated from A.J. Beatty with the offensive rebound, ladies and gentlemen.
A.J. Beatty,
A.J. Beatty.
6'3", grade 10.
Grade 10, ladies and gentlemen.
Bright future, A.J. Beatty.
He has a bright future here.
He's got to wear shades. Got some AC/DC pumping in the... Nothing better than AC/DC in the Brit gym. We got crowd members trying to... I told you I was Famous Amos. They want autographs while I'm working.
While he's working. Ladies and gentlemen,
volunteering
fans are coming
my
up
time.
To get autographs here. We're going to have to get some
security.
We've
got to
get
say,
security now.
Well, I was doing it. I might as well do security, too.
Security. We need that personnel security.
Yep. Get this man a guard.
I'm going to check our budget here and see
if
we have
Sam's fouled out. We can bring him over.
Yeah. There we have the Aiden Bowman Bears already on standby and the Raymond Comets here, ladies and gentlemen. That is a marquee matchup.
Marquee
matchup.
All right, 68-64, Harry Ainley out of Edmonton, Alberta. Bethlehem Stars they're gonna need their lucky stars here if they're gonna.
Bethlehem made the decision to advance the ball.
Okay.
They will now have 20, they will have 14 seconds on the shot clock. Yep. Exactly.
You know your
that
rules.
That is the decision.
You read the rule book for
yes,
this tournament. Didn't
yes.
you brush it up on stuff?
Yes. And Juma from number five from Bethlehem gets it exactly what he wanted.
Of course, Juma the Puma, baby.
And they put Akon Dang to with that little bit of size mismatch, and Akon Dang comes up big with that block. That size advantage is tough.
Akon
Dang is coming in clutch here.
Yeah, he's really stepped it up in the second half.
He's really stepped.
You're saying his name a lot, like a lot, like you're saying it a lot.
He's back. He's back. And Bethlehem Stars are. What are they going to run? Number five, Juma has been having the hot hand. Let's see if they go to him. They tried to. Maurice Oronda saved it.
Yeah, that was a clever play there.
That was a good save by Maurice Oronda.
Shoveled it off of him there.
Yep. They're going to make the change because he's a little short on the inbounds play, but Patia Tombe is going to make this as he's a little bit height and easier to make that pass.
Okay, folks.
Look for Osagie in the middle, but Jacob Houston is going to try and cut off that pass.
If you're tuning in to watch Raymond against Aiden Bowman, relax. We're a little behind. Pep rally ran a little long earlier this afternoon.
The kids were having big excitement.
They're having a heyday. And you
Maurice
know what? That's okay.
Oronda, Patia Tombe. Boom! Ladies and gentlemen, what a three. Wow. The crowd just went wild. Patia Tombe comes up clutch, and Harry Ainley calls a timeout.
With 13.9 seconds left.
That is
folks,
big.
Turn your cars off. Come back inside.
What a clutch three.
This is not over. Plug your car back in. We're going to be here all night.
Let's see. The coaches are now playing chess. There's 14 seconds left.
This is where it gets interesting.
This is where it gets interesting.
If I could be a fly on the wall. I mean, what do you want to be here? You want to be like a drone, like hovering above.
A drone
hovering above. That's what we need in here. You know how we elevate Brit? Let's get a drone camera.
A drone.
A little drone that buzzes around the gym. That's safe.
It's safe. Unfortunately, Bethlehem has five fouls, so anytime they foul,
that's right. They're going to the line.
Harry Ainley is going to go to the free throw line. So he has to make a decision. Let's see what he decides to do. I have a feeling he is going to foul. He's going to go for the steal.
Yeah.
And then he's going to go for the he's going to have to
and
foul
then just
after.
Roll the dice there with the free throws.
And Harry Ainley is going to want to pass that ball as quick as they possibly can. But they're going to put it in their strongest free throw line shooter here.
Okay. And that you believe that's
Jacob Houston.
Yep.
Jacob Houston, ladies and gentlemen.
Give it to Houston.
Yep, give it to Houston.
Houston, we have a problem. We need to win this basketball game.
Yep.
I don't know where this voice came from.
That is what happens, ladies and gentlemen.
When you drink cola.
Britt brings out the best in us. Okay, Harry Ainley.
Better not get heartburn.
Yep. Let's see if they look for Jacob Houston.
I'll need an effervescent tablet.
There is a little mismatch out there. Akon Dang and Maurice Oronda. Let's see if they take advantage of that. Nope. AJ Beatty. Yep, they're looking for the foul. Leanne Gonzalez.
Why is he feel moved?
Ladies and gentlemen, AJ Beatty was sent to the free throw line.
We're going to need a call out for a camera person next game because I don't see my next cameraman signed up.
AJ Beatty going to the free throw line with a 1-point lead. Grade 10. The crowd is now stomping the floor.
Yes, I always wonder, would you use that as fuel?
AJ Beatty just used it as fuel as he swished it. He looks calm and cool out there.
Calm and cool.
It's like he's in his backyard just shooting hoops.
He's done this his whole life.
And he does, unfortunately. But Harry Ainley steps out of bounds. Calm Majok. Wow, what a finish.
Okay.
Bethlehem now gets the ball with a timeout left.
It's not over, folks.
Now,
it's never over.
What would you do? You are down by two.
I would shake the magic eight ball. I would shake it, and I would get advice from that bubble
thing. Holy man.
I got one somewhere in my basement.
Yowzy wants to go to the basketball gods.
Yeah, I would leave it in the hands
of
the gods.
He's going to the basketball gods.
Yeah, I would shake that magic eight ball. I'd say, what do you say?
Yes. I personally love to live on the dark side, so I would go for the win.
I thought you were going to say the Ouija board.
I would show the Ouija board. I would shoot the three. I want this crowd to go wild.
Okay, so you would put it all in.
Put it all in. Put it in Juma's hands. Juma is the hot hand.
Okay, so you're going Juma for three.
Juma for three.
I got to burn home, get my magic eight ball, give it a shake.
Yep.
Figure out what I'm going to do.
What are we going to do here?
Okay.
I have a feeling.
I got to see if I can find somebody reliable in the crowd to jump up and film this next game.
Let's see who inbounds the ball.
We got an overactive camera person up here.
9 seconds is still a long time in this game, ladies and gentlemen. 9 seconds is an
eternity. Feels like a lifetime when you have to go to the washroom.
This is a life, telling you. A lifetime.
I'm telling you, folks, we need to wrap this one up. I got to go to the washroom.
Juma,
Raymond, if you're tuning in, they're up next against Aiden Bowman.
Look for a dribble handoff. Juma is going to inbound the ball, and he might come off a screen here. Exactly what we call Petia Tombo. No, Petia Tombe. Oh, he's got his dribble still.
He's got to get the shot
step back. Wow, that was a tough one. Harry
and that's
Ainley.
It, folks. Harry Ainley, 69. Bethlehem, 67.
What a finish, ladies and
that's
gentlemen.
A good game.
What a finish.
Bethlehem will be in the red eye tomorrow against Bedford Road at
this
8 a.m.
Beautiful. What a fantastic game here. What a fantastic game.
Harry Ainley got 69 points.
Harry Ainley with the win.
They will be taking on. They will be playing at 9:15 if you're tuning in from Edmonton. Harry Ainley, 9:15 Saskatchewan time.
Saskatchewan time.
We don't do that daylight savings action here.
I don't even know what daylight savings is.
What is that?
What is that? I don't know what it is.
Silly, silly idea made by silly, silly people.
I'm going to cut the bottom of my blanket and sew it on top. That is what I think they're doing. I don't know, ladies and gentlemen.
I love it. Yes. Okay, folks, we're going to Famous Amos and Foxtrot signing off.
We'll sign off.
Next
we'll
up
see.
Is the A-side. We've got our first look at Aiden Bowman, late edition, against reigning defending champions, Raymond Alberta. Yeah. The Comets.
The Comets.
I'm Jacob. Harry Ainley, grade 11.
How do you feel about your game?
It was good. We showed a lot of effort, defense, got our runs. We sacrificed our body, you know, took a lot of charges.
Yeah.
I like that from my teammates. So.
How's your journey been so far at Edward?
It's pretty nice, yeah. Saskatoon's a great town. Like the fans are awesome.
How do you feel about like being in the gym? Because I feel like not a lot of people experience grid, and especially being in grade 11, it's pretty good, awesome experience, right? So how would you like please elaborate?
It's pretty crazy. Like the atmosphere here is insane. Like fans are getting wild for rebounds, man.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
And any expectations you want to set up for yourself for next game?
Win. We win. We play hard. You know? Put our bodies online. If we lose, then you know what? We try, you know?
And it was a pretty close game. And so, like, how did you manage all, like, that stress and that pressure?
Well, we're a team, you know, our whole thing is based on attitude. You know, we're attitude first. We're not going down after they go on a run or something like that. You know, fourth quarter, we just let them go on, like, a 6-0 run, something like that. And, you know, first thing everyone's saying, we're going to the huddle, attitude, next play, you know? Like, we're good.
Awesome. Thank you so much for being here, and good luck for your next game.